Welcome students, in another session of Animal Kingdom Part 4. Here we will discuss about excrementers, which are also known as roundworm. The grade of organization, they show the organ system of organization. Symmetry is bilateral symmetry. Germinal layer, they are the first organism that shows the triploblastic organism. Flatworms also shows the triploblastic organism, but these organisms shows the coelom in the form of pseudocoelom. That is a false cavity. That means mesoderm is in the pouch. Habit and habitat, they are aquatic and terrestrial. Some are free living and some are parasitic as well. Parasite that live inside the plants and in animals. Digestive system is complete. It has both the mouth and anus. Tubular alimentary canal is present with a well-developed muscular pharynx. So here in the diagram, you can see that it shows the mouth, anus. Intestine is also present, pseudocoelomate, as they have. Ovary is also present, nerve ring as well, and pharynx are also present. Respiratory system is absent, but they show they respire through the skin, cutaneous respiration. Circulatory system is also absent. Reproduction. Organisms are dioecious. The meaning of dioecious is sexes are separate. Usually this organism performs sexual reproduction. The type of fertilization is internal. Development is indirect as well as direct. So both the type of development is observed, that is development indirect and direct. The unique feature is body is circular in cross section. If you do the TS of this, if you study the TS of this organism, then you'll find that body is entire a circular in nature. That's why they are rounded warm, as well as you'll find that the edges are a bit curved. They have the syncytial epidermis. That means the epidermis with many nucleus. Here you can see epidermis is there, but there are so many nucleus present in it. And they have thick cuticle into it. The other type of unique feature is an excretory tube to remove body waste is present, and they excrete out through pores. So here you can see it in the diagram that they have a special type of excretory tube and an excretory pore through which they releases their body waste. They also show sexual dimorphism. Dimorphism, that is morphologically, there is a difference between males and females. Males are usually shorter than females. So we can say that females are longer than male in terms of excrementers, that is roundworms. Here are the few examples. Ascaris, roundworms, hookworms, then Fusaria, that is filarial worm, which is responsible for elephant foot. Ascaris also lives, act as a parasite that lives inside the human intestine. Entire phylum at a glance. The organism shows organ level of system, symmetry is bilateral, germinal layer, they are triploblastic. They show the pseudocoelomate. Organisms are aquatic or terrestrial, even free living and parasitic. Type of digestive system is complete. Respiratory system is absent. Circulatory system is absent. Reproduction, they are dioecious. Sexual reproduction takes place. Indirect fertilization, internal fertilization takes place. And development is both direct as well as indirect. The unique feature, they have multinucleated epidermis. They show the thick cuticle, excretory tube is absent. Instead of that, they remove the waste through, they have the excretory tube to remove body waste through excretory pore. Sexually, they are dimorphism, and examples are Ascaris vischeria. Now moving ahead with another phylum, which is Annelida. These are ringed or segmented worms. Organ system of organization is present, bilateral symmetry is there. These organisms are triploblastic as well as coelomate, as you can see in the diagram here. They have the dorsal vessel, that means blood vessel. Blood circulatory system is also present. Setae, coelom is there that lead to having the intestinal lumen. Vertical blood vessels, they also have the ventral nerve cord. They show the circular muscle, longitudinal muscle. All these characteristics we'll learn in the unique features. Habit and habitat, they are terrestrial, freshwater or marine. Organisms are free living as well as parasitic in nature. Digestive system is complete with mouth and anus. Respiratory system, they show the cutaneous respiration, that means through their skin. Some have branchial gills, that helps them in respiration. Circulatory system is closed type with dorsal ventral blood vessels, dorsal as well as ventral blood vessels and heart. Reproduction, they are sexual organisms. Earthworm and leeches are monoecious. Monoecious, that means both the sexes are present in same organism. Whereas Meris is dioecious. That means male and female organisms are different. Development is indirect. Unique feature. Segmentation like rings are present on their Annelida, they show longitudinal as well as circular muscles that help them in locomotion. Here you can see in the diagram that they have the circular muscles as well as longitudinal muscles that help them in locomotion. Locomotory organs are setae in earthworm, whereas parapodia in Neris. Unique feature is they have nephridia as an excretory organ. So this is the unique feature, that in earthworms, in all the Annelida, they have nephridia for excretion. They have the paired ganglion connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. So here you can see in the diagram they have entire nervous system. The paired ganglions, here are the paired ganglions in every segment, which give rise to these lateral double ventral nerve, and it forms the double ventral nerve cord. Here are the examples of Annelida: earthworm, leech, Neris. Annelida at a glance. Organism shows organ system, bilateral symmetry, germinal layer is triploblastic, coelomate organism. Organisms are terrestrial, freshwater, marine, free-living parasite, digestive system is complete, respiration is cutaneous, that is through skin, branchial respiration, that means they have the gills for respiration, circulatory system is closed, reproduction is through sexual only, earthworm and leeches are monoecious, and Neris is dioecious, development is direct, indirect. True segmentation, longitudinal and circular muscles are present, locomotory organ is setae or parapodia. Examples are Neris, Prechinema, Hirudinaria. Thanks for watching.